जीडी बेस्ड लीगल एक्सरसाइज नंबर 27 बी रेडी स्टार्ट द असेसी ए कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटी एंगेज्ड इन द बिजनेस ऑफ प्रोवाइडिंग क्रेडिट फैसिलिटीज टू इट्स मेंबर्स एंड मार्केटिंग देयर एग्रीकल्चरल प्रोड्यूस इन्वेस्टेड द सरप्लस फंड्स इन शॉर्ट टर्म डिपॉजिट्स with the banks and in government securities and earned interest thereon. The assessee showed the said interest income under the head income from business, but the assessing officer assessed it as income from other sources under section 56 and held that the assessee would not be entitled to deduction under section 80(p)(2)(a) of the Income Tax Act. In the instant appeal filed by the assessee, the question for consideration before the court was whether the interest income earned by the assessee society on surplus funds invested in short-term deposits would qualify for deduction as business income under section 80(p)(2)(a) of the Income Tax Act 1961. Dismissing the appeals, the court held an income which is attributable to any of the activities specified in section 80(p)(2)(a) the Income Tax Act 1961 would be eligible for deduction. In the instant case, the interest held not eligible for deduction under section 80(p)(2)(a) is not the interest received from the businesses of the society, namely providing credit facilities to its members or marketing their agricultural produce. What is sought to be taxed under section 56 of the Act is the interest income arising on the surplus, which surplus was not required for business purposes and was invested in specified securities as investment. Assessee markets the produce of its members whose sale proceeds at times were retained by it. Since the fund created by such retention was not required immediately for business purposes, it was invested in specified securities, such interest income would come in the category of income from other sources and therefore would be taxable under section 56 of the Act as rightly held by the assessing officer. Para, the word income has been defined under section 224(i) of the Act to include profits and gains. This subsection is an inclusive provision. The Parliament has included specifically businesses' profits into the definition of the word income. Therefore, the court is required to give a precise meaning to the words profits and gains of business mentioned in section 80(p)(2) of the Act. In the instant case, assessee society regularly invest funds not required for business purpose. Interest on such investment cannot fall within the meaning of the expression profits and gain of business.